God. Now the King James Version, 1 Thessalonians chapter 4. Now this is Paul, you know, Paul, he wrote this letter, the book of Thessalonians, to encourage, you know, new believers in their faith. And not only that, to also exhort them, you know, to godly living. Praise God. To give them an assurance. That's why Paul wrote this letter to the Thessalonians. Amen. The Christians there. An assurance about, you know, the eternal state of every believer. Praise God. Those even who have died. And also to defend the integrity of ministry. Praise God. You know, Thessalonica in our day right now is called Thessaloniki, and that's in Greece. It used to be the capital of Rome, Macedonia. Praise God. Amen. So right now, Paul wrote in chapter 4 this letter to the Christians there after Timothy was sent in chapter 3. But chapter 4 says, furthermore, then we beseech you, brethren, and exhort you by the Lord Jesus, that as ye have received of us how ye ought to walk and to please God, so ye would abound more and more. 2, that ye know what commandments we gave you by the Lord Jesus Christ. For this is the will of God, even your sanctification, that ye abstain from fornication, that every one of you should know how to possess his vessel in sanctification and honor. 5, not in lust of concupiscence, even as the Gentiles which know not God. 6, that no man go beyond and defraud his brother in any matter, because that the Lord is the avenger of all such, as we also have forewarned you and testified. For God has not called us unto uncleanness, but unto holiness. 8, he therefore that despiseth not man, but God, who hath also given us his Holy Spirit. 9, but as touching brotherly love, ye need not know not that I write unto you, for ye yourselves are taught of God to love one another. And indeed ye do it towards all the brethren which are in Macedonia. But we beseech you, brethren, that ye increase more and more. Praise God. 11 says, and that you study to be quiet and to do your own business, to work with your own hands as we commanded you, that ye may walk honestly towards them that are without, and that ye may have lack of nothing. Verse 13 says, but I would have not have you to be ignorant, brethren, concerning them which are asleep, that ye sorrow not, even as others which have no hope. For if we believe that Jesus died and rose again, even so then also we which sleep in Jesus will God bring with him. 15 says, for this we say unto you by the word of the Lord, that we which are alive and remain unto the coming of the Lord shall not prevent them which are asleep. For the Lord himself shall descend from heaven with a shout, hallelujah, and the voice of the archangel, and with the trump of God, and the dead in Christ shall rise first. 17 says, then we which are alive and remain shall be caught up together with them in the clouds to meet the Lord in the air, and so shall we ever be with the Lord. And verse 18 says, wherefore comfort one another with these words. Heavenly Father, we comfort ourselves with these words, and we ask that even as the word goes forth, our hearts, our minds, our spirits, Lord, is connected to this grace, to this truth, to this wisdom. And we are sanctified in your holiness to do the right thing. We give you praise, Father. In Jesus' precious and wonderful name we pray. Amen and amen. Praise God.